Let's begin by considering the following riddle. Two agents, Alice and Bob, are each led into a closed room. Their respective rooms are located on opposite sides of our galaxy, allowing no form of communication. In her room, Alice finds a collection of golden coins with a Q engraved on them. After inspecting them for a while, she starts to toss them one after another. All coin flips show heads or tails at random, and neither Alice nor Bob nor anyone else can predict or influence the outcome. Nonetheless, across the galaxy and without even a second's delay, Bob begins to write down the result of each coin toss. Though light years away, he denotes all of Alice's random results correctly. How is this possible? Don't worry, this isn't some type of logic riddle designed to test your intelligence. In fact, even if you gather the smartest people that lived up until the 20th century, they had practically no chance explaining this, as they were unaware of the incredible mechanism in nature that makes this possible. It gets worse, even if you gave them the solution to this riddle, they would likely not believe you, unless you dragged them into a high-tech physics lab and demonstrated it in front of their eyes. This hard-to-believe phenomenon I'm talking about is called quantum entanglement, with the nickname spooky action at a distance brought forward by Albert Einstein, and it is one of those things that from its first discussion in 1935 to its technological implementation today has caused a lot of headaches for scientists around the world. So let's turn back to the intro. How can Bob know Alice's random outcomes as soon as she does? Well, the only possible explanation is that Bob also has coins, which somewhere in the past have been quantum entangled with Alice's coins. This sort of synchronizes the behavior of the two coins, so that by measuring his coin, Bob knows exactly what Alice has measured. As a first-order approximation, the entanglement of two coins can be thought of as an invisible connection between them that causes them to behave as if they were merged into one object. Regardless where they are in space, the two coins are no longer independent. Instead, you could think of them as two sides of the same coin, so that Alice and Bob, though light years apart, are actually flipping segments of the same thing. Now, depending on the entanglement protocol, they will, at least for the first throw, either observe the same or opposite outcomes with full certainty, because the measurement that they are doing is being done on the same unified system. This analogy of the two coins merging isn't perfect, but it conveys a very important concept, namely that one coin revealing heads does not cause the other coin to also show heads. There's no information traveling from one coin to the other. Instead, what Alice and Bob see are actually observations of the same event. Let's recap. The quantum entanglement of two coins integrates them into a shared quantum state. If you now flip the coins, their outcomes will still be random, but they will also be perfectly coordinated. The spooky part is that no matter how far the entangled objects are apart, or how much you try to shield them off, there always seems to be something that reaches them and guides their actions. Physicists call this strange effect non-local correlation, where non-local refers to the fact that it cannot be explained by considering two independent coins that talk to each other. Instead, this only works via a unified entity that does not need to travel through space and time, but seems to be everywhere at once. The underlying idea that quantum objects don't necessarily have a definite position was already introduced in my last video and is ultimately a consequence of the superposition principle, the core paradigm of quantum mechanics. However, entanglement presents an extreme case of this idea, as it not only occurs on the atomic scale, but has actually been demonstrated over distances spanning hundreds of kilometers. Now, before talking about the technological applications of this remarkable effect, I'd like to make some final remarks for sakes of completeness that extend beyond the simple pictures from before. Firstly, once Alice tosses her coin, the system decoheres, meaning that subsequent throws will not display the entanglement. Secondly, these Q-engraved coins aren't the ordinary coins which you use for transactions, which would at least be very, very difficult to bring into the state. Instead, you can just imagine that these Q coins contain a tiny device that measures a quantum property such as the spin of an electron and causes the coin to land on heads or tails depending on what it measures. Now, this measurement outcome is completely random. There's no way to predict or influence it. Physicists were recently able to verify that there's nothing inside the entangled coins that predetermines the outcome of the next coin flip. Since the outcome is random and uncontrollable, it is also impossible to use non-local correlations to directly transmit information. So entanglement does not allow something like faster-than-light communication. With this out of the way, let's look at some use cases. Now, while I could do an entire video about entanglement applications, the two quantum technologies I'd like to focus on here are quantum computing and quantum communication. Quantum computing is the elephant in the room and would bring a very noticeable change to the world when realized. Its calculations are based on entangled ensembles of many qubits, which are even harder to realize than the entangled state of just two objects that we've seen before. Still, there are some proof-of-concept devices which are steadily advancing in development. Quantum communication, on the other hand, is, especially in the form of quantum cryptography, already operational and commercially available. In fact, it is the provably most secure way to encrypt messages known today. Yet, while extensively researched by countries like the US and China, it is not widely employed as its complexity generally outweighs the benefits. Besides cryptography, there are also quantum communication schemes that, for example, allow to efficiently compress data using entangled qubits. Though again, setting this up isn't particularly easy and hence not yet done outside research. Generally speaking, entanglement-based technologies are still in their infancy. But it still amazes me how we're not only able to find such crazy effects in nature, but are also able to make use of them. Thanks for watching.